Hello, welcome back. You remember this game? It's been a little while. A new version came out while I was playing Eye of the Atlantis. If you're not familiar with this, this is a dungeon crawler, kind of like Legend of Grimrock, which I played through a little bit. I got 15 episodes in, and I ran into a problem where the save system just completely stopped functioning, pretty much. Saving was taking longer and longer, and eventually it came to a point where when the game would save, it would actually lose a bunch of data and be kind of in a weird error state where a lot of the floors I had been to had gotten uncleared. Tab does this. Space does this. I need to get reacquainted with controls and things. Attacks are... Okay, I can press Z, X, C, V to do this. Left click. Oh boy, that's gonna throw me off. Anyway, so an update to this game came out while I was in the middle of Eye of the Atlantis, which apparently completely reworked the save system. When I started this up, it had a screen telling me it was converting my old saves. They appear to be intact. I loaded from, I think, what was the best one? I had just gotten a Zorb of Mana out of someplace. Was it over there? Yeah, right here. Okay. That's basically as up-to-date as it gets before the saves started corrupting. Do I have a... How do I view... What's the map key? M. I don't have one, though. I think I'm going this way. Anyway, yeah, so apparently the old save system was registry-based. Like, it actually saved in the Windows registry, which seems just insane to me. I never would have thought that that would be something anyone would do. Every time I go upstairs, it auto-saves. Let's see how long this takes. That is very, very, very much quicker. Like, it took several seconds, but it was pushing 20 seconds last time I was doing it. So this looks... Initially, this looks way more playable. So let's hope that this continues behaving, and I can actually finish the game now. Those seem brighter than they used to be. Okay, so I took a quick peek at the last episode that I was able to do for this, just to kind of get my bearings and have an idea of what I'm trying to do here. Level 13, I think it was where I was. Maybe not quite that far. No, I wasn't on level 13. It was earlier than that. But anyway, some level or another, there was a sign that said weapon binding, which taught me... Chest has been emptied. Caused me to figure out how to put objects on the ground, which I had not figured out until then. Do I own a map of this? I do. Good. So that's, not Windgate. What are those called? Teleporter. I don't think I can... Yeah, I can't put markers on this map. Anyway, yeah, so I'm heading backwards to pick up a shield to put in a place that was marked shield binding, because it was going to open some sort of secret thing. Here we go, yeah. I wanted to come here, pick up this junky old shield. Yes, give it to me. Yes, give it to me. I don't need anything else in this pile, as far as I know. Do I want a junky old weapon? Did I already use a junky old weapon? That's a junky old weapon. I can use that. Okay. Hopefully I don't need any of that other stuff. Yeah, so, a lot of this is just going to be sort of remembering how the game works and how to play it. It's coming back to me quicker than I expected it to. I believe it was December the last time I played this, so... It's been a few months, which is some amount of time, but it could be worse. But yeah, like, this was a super cool game. It, you know, it has its rough edges, but I was enjoying my time playing it, and I'm glad that I have the opportunity to play it again. I was hoping I'd be able to finish eventually. Are you going? Yeah, okay, that was like 7 seconds. That's still, like, way more tolerable than it was. I can deal with 7 seconds. And no indication so far of any save corruption happening. I will know when it happens because... Ooh, that's scary. Because if I was going downstairs, I stop going down the stairs and the game seems all confused, or if I autosave, the window doesn't close or something, I'll be able to tell, is what I'm saying. Alright, so on the way down, last time I did this, what is the way down? Which way am I going? I have no map. Oh boy. Yeah, so this game is not nearly as generous with its maps as others of its type. I think this is the wrong way. That was like sub-level something or other. That's treasure. I just want to see if I'll hit a dead end here or if this is actually a way forward. Oh, hey, herbs. Neat. I'll take that. Something looks different about the graphics. It's more... like this... these horizontal lines in the dithering. What's up with those? Those weren't there before, I think. I don't know if you can see that after video encoding, but it's different. Oh yeah, so this had a story and stuff. And it was fairly interesting. Intruder, presence skulking, Theraborn. I'm not going to remember the names of things, or people's voices, or stuff. But I remember the writing in this game being actually surprisingly really good. I don't know why I say surprisingly, but pretty good. Very competent. So I look forward to learning more about the story. If I had had time, I would have reviewed my entire LP up to this point, but I don't have the time to watch 15 episodes of that. Okay, I think this is a spot that I noticed. Yeah, there's a bullseye there. That gold moved. It used to be here. I was just looking at this footage. Minor diversion differences, I guess. Okay. So yeah, there was a side passage here. I need to... you're gonna hit the rat. Oh, shoot. Can I change equipment real quick? Oh, no. Here, you do it. Ah, rat got in the way again. Go away, rat. That's weakness. That's the wrong wand to use for this. Hit the bullseye. There you go. If I'm gonna be fighting aggressively, I want a different wand. How do I... okay, so right-click to unequip. That's ice. There's fire. I think fire was the one I wanted. Yeah, equip. Equip. How do I... double-click? There we go. Meanwhile, I'm getting attacked by a rat. That's okay. Rats were the first enemy I ever encountered. They're not too threatening. This is a good way to get reacquainted with the combat system and stuff. Right, I cannot move while my attacks are on cooldown. So I have to stay in place. However, backstabs are a thing. Backstabs exist. They do a lot of damage. Hey, a map! Nice! That's good for me. Okay, so I got a map. Doesn't really tell me where I was going, so I'm just gonna have to hope I kind of remember. Yeah, so I remember. Backstabs were a thing. It seemed worthwhile. It seemed worthwhile to try to actually move around during combat, even though the game discourages it. Get behind things, stab them in the back. Even though I'm gonna be locked into place once I make an attack. I seem to remember that all pits are instant death, but the party won't just willingly walk off one. I have to be dropped down a trapdoor to be dropped. I think that's it. I don't really feel like testing that right now. I'm not getting hassles about delete some saves to increase performance, so maybe that problem has been fixed. Although, I guess it's just autosaves here. Well, but yeah, it still complained about that when it was autosaves. Okay, so I'm on floor 9. Ah, shield binding is right here. Isn't it? Yeah, shield binding, right here. Mm-hmm. So I got my shield somewhere. Let's see, I want to double-click to grab, press close, then click here. That thing is permanently there. I can't pick it up anymore because it's bound. But that opens this, where it is a chest. With a better shield. Exceptional steel shield. Yes, take all. And some gold. Who uses shields? You do. You have a steel shield 3, which is protection plus 3. You have wooden shield 3, protection plus 3, just as good. You can't use one because your hands are full, you can't use one because your hands are full. And maybe you're the wrong class, I'm not actually sure. Plus 4, okay. Cool. I can probably just ditch that old steel shield. It doesn't seem like there's a reason to carry around stuff. If I want to drop something... drop. Selected a drop. Selected drop. Selected item. What's this? Chainmail suit plus 4 plus 5. If I'm getting rid of stuff, let's get rid of some stuff. You can't wear chainmail, right? Yeah. Anyway, drop. Drop. Okay, cool. So, the way down, I still don't have a map. That has not changed in the last few seconds. Now I need to find my way down. Is this it? All fours. Yeah, I remember. I did 4 thingies somehow to open this door somehow. What are these green bars? Those are experience, I guess? Because, yeah, I don't think there's a stamina system. It's just attacks go on cooldown when I use something. That one's mana. My wizard does run out of mana. I remember that I can set left-hand or right-hand attack as the default. Like, Ikeb back here is using a bow right now, because I have so many arrows. It does more damage than the sword, I believe, even in melee range. Yeah, I remember this spot. This had some sort of secret I could never figure out how to access. Now, how do I get where I want to go? I still have no map. Oh boy. Since I just autosaved... Okay, party will not walk forward onto open pit willingly. They have to be dropped down a thing. So there's a teleporter here. Might this be the way I want to go? How would I know? Where am I? Button won't budge. I'm on the other side of that grid of stuff. But there's nothing... Oh wait, no, there's a way to go. Like, it's a long journey back to... Maybe it was floor 13 where the weapon binding was. I'll know it when I see it. Floor 11. I remember a dark place with a pool. I fought a mole there. Then the stairs are in, like, a square room with... Doesn't really help to describe it. Yeah, this place. That's the one, right there, where my cursor is. So... bare left, kinda. Alright. This way, right? Yes. What is my healing potion status? I have 3, I have 15 empty flasks, I have 1 red reed. If I do this, yes, I can make a potion. Those come in very handy during combat. I have a lot of blue reeds. I don't find myself needing mana nearly as much. Oh hey, another stash of junk. Alright, anyway, the way forward was here. This was the floor that I never got to fully experience because my save broke. So let's do it now. Eventually. Press G to open the save game dialog. Thanks for letting me know. I have an autosave. Those get overwritten. Oh, right. Yeah, weapon binding. Yes, I went back to a save right before I did that because I had a theory that doing this and leaving was what broke my save file. Okay, I'm going to save. Make a hard save here. Floor 12 for real. Yes, that saved. Good. Alright. Protection binding. Oh, okay. Maybe I shouldn't have tossed out that suit of armor. There was... Oh, I hear something stomping. Gonna get to do some combat. There was some armor back up there. I assume protection means a suit of armor. Got some junk up here. That should work fine. I should have guessed that there would be more bindings. But I wouldn't have been able to guess what. Water holes, yes. Reeds grow there. Let's see if any have grown here. Answer is no, I don't see any. I need to hang out in that area to let them grow. Yes, pick that up. Chainmail armor suit. Don't think I can do anything with those boxes. Last time I tried, I couldn't find any way to interact with them. But, like, it took me until... well, I'd say now, until 4 months ago when I last played this to figure out how to put an item down on the ground in a specific spot. So there totally could be interactions with things like that that I just don't know about. Alright, protection binding. You go here. Close and place. Yeah! Alright, so in here are ogres. Have I fought those before? They don't look especially familiar? Weakness. Weakness was very much worth it. Use weakness. Weakness is amazing. Ouch. My keys, my buttons, my fingers are in the wrong place. I would like to back off for some reason. Will that help me? Are you weakened? Right, yeah. Okay, so combat here. I remember. This was all about managing, being extremely aware of whether weakness was successful or not. It was not here. Okay, right. If somebody dies, they will actually just come back on their own, and that can happen mid-combat. So as long as all four people are not dead at the same time... Critical damage, good job. Okay, so you shot, already weakened. Let's see, I can use the quarterstaff, weakness expired. I could use... See, now let's see what happens if I don't use a potion. Because, like, I can just... Okay, wait, you resisted. I need to keep weakening you. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. I survived. You have come back already, I think. Good. I think you might have gotten that experience. I'm going to run away. There isn't a rest key, is there? So if I want to rest, I have to just wait in real time, I seem to remember. And that's kind of unfortunate. Or drink potions, which are a very limited resource, as it turns out. Well, if I'm going to hang out somewhere and rest, it might as well be here where the herbs might grow and I might be able to make more potions. That'd be nice. Yeah, I forgot about this part of the game. This is kind of unfortunate. Is there, like... I guess there's no help that I can get too easily here. Okay, well... Oh, hey! An herb grew. Yep. I'll hang out here for a little while, let people's health regenerate, then go down and fight that other ogre. You know what? I'm tired of this. This takes too long. Let's just see if I can fight the ogre like this. Since the death system is so forgiving, it's actually hard for everybody to die all at once in combat. Here, let me go ahead and just... Since I got two red herbs from... red reeds from sitting there for that long, I'll brew some. And just in case, like, I'm down to one party member, I'll drink a potion. Yeah, that'll be my strategy. If I'm down to one party member and they're taking damage, I'll drink a potion. I can also run away, since I'm going to be right next to the stairs here. Health and manage, regenerate slowly. Yep. Ogre should be right in front of me. Yeah, pretty much. Let me, oops, what did I just do? I attacked so I couldn't move. That's what happened. Alright, so you attack everybody in the party. That's okay, yeah, so I'm in that situation. I want you two to drink potions. So you're weakened, that's good. You came back, but then died. Okay, so... Ogre is weakened. Yeah, okay, so the problem is his attacks hit everybody. I'm gonna die if I stay here. Okay, I think I'm going up the stairs. Alright, so ogres are nasty. I don't think there's much other activities I can really do. I could wander around and hope I find something new, maybe. I guess I'll do that while I recover. Well, I've waited as long as I'm willing to wait. Two people have pretty much fully recovered. One is about two-thirds of the way there. I'll just hope she survives. So that took a few minutes. I had some reading to do. I really wish there were a rest key or, you know, some other way to regenerate health quickly when I'm not in combat. Because, like, just sitting there is not, you know, not something I'm going to be doing while I'm recording this. Be weakened. Yeah, you're weakened. That is good for me. Alright, so, again, combat is all about managing the weakness. So I can get one attack in here, then I want her to wait a little bit. Yeah, weakness in fact expired. Do it again. Five turns. How long is a turn, though? It's kind of unclear. Other one went down after not too much time. You should be nearly dead by now. Okay, weakness expired, weakness applied. Yes. See, he's not killing me. This is why weakness is important. Aw, he killed me. Alright, I'll be fine. I think. Just don't do too many of those sweeping attacks. A little bit more. Alright, you're weakened. Great. That was her only action before she died again. I could use healing potions, but I just... just don't want to. There we go. Alright, ability point gained. Cool. What the heck was I doing with people to level them up, I wonder? I guess you were getting dexterity, probably? What do you use? Oh yeah, I had to guess what the stats do because they don't have tooltips or anything. Right, you could use strength with the short bow. I'm assuming dexterity would be the stat that would make the short bow do more damage. Right, you can't use long bows. That's a warrior-only... warrior? Fighter-only weapon for some reason. But you can use a short bow. That's your primary weapon. Dexterity, if there's any stat that makes it better, it would probably be dexterity. So that's what I've done. Okay, cool. Ogres are dead. Most of my party's alive. All of my party's alive now, actually. Neat. Sure, let's use some of those. Well, that's enough potions to use for stuff. If I wanted to. Got more arrows, that's good. That didn't do anything obvious. It didn't tell me about anything it did. Money. Rocks can be mined if I have a pickaxe. I do. It gave me a rogue's toolkit. Cool. And the pickaxe survived. Neat. That's a rock I can pick up and carry. I'm not ready to yet. Spike traps can be hidden under these. Two! Okay, this is side number two. I need a key first, I guess. So here's a button. That didn't work. Do I need to press them? Oh, do I need a combination? I hope this is not the sort of thing where there was a clue for this a long time ago and I haven't played the game for 4 months, so I have no idea what that clue might have been. Don't give me blue reeds. I don't need those. I have way too many already. So here's a rock. what do I do with the block? The only thing that resembles a hint that I get here is the sign that says 2. I was going to interpret that as being the place I go second. There's a block. There are buttons. So blocks usually go on pressure plates. I'm going to match. Did that actually do something? I was putting it there to match the box that's on the other side of that button. This is for symmetry. I thought I heard something, but it was probably just that heavy clanking thing that's wandering around, whatever it is. Okay, so, oh hey, there's money. So a puzzle. Sometimes there are loose bricks. Sometimes my party will notice them. Let's press buttons randomly. Nothing happens. That's a pit. Can't go there. So, what other information do I have? Not really much of any at all. What could I be missing? Do the torches here... Wait, what's this? Three. Oh, I didn't even notice that there was this passage here. So I could be missing more than just that. Okay, so let's check the full perimeter of this room. So this is two. Three is on the opposite side. Then there's buttons and pits here. Presumably some combination of those buttons would close those trapdoors so I could cross... Well, now, hang on. I've been... Oh yeah, and the block was here, and that's everything. This is the way I came in. Okay, so two and three are here and here. Buttons are here. Like, it's just three buttons. I don't possess a clue for this that I know about. So, two. Three. Nothing's happening with this. So yeah, I need to know a code, it seems. But I don't know a code. Can I form any theories about where the stone might go? All this creaking. There's nothing unusual about this particular torch. Do I have a key? Doesn't seem like it. Oh, hey, what the? I have Zorbs that have not been used. Oh. Well, let's give that to her. How do I use it? Possession of this Zorb grants all party members an additional 15% mana. It's not consumed, I just hold it. I see. All party members. Yeah, I thought you gave it to a specific one. Maybe that changed? Now, those are taking up slots in my inventory. It's 35 out of 40. It's fairly full. I'm gonna have to ditch some of these old wands or something maybe someday. Why do I have this? I assume that's worse than what I'm using. You probably can't use it. That's better. That's better. Okay. Blood dragged over there. So yeah, that seems darker than the other buttons for some reason. There's no, like, long pits that might have a bullseye at the other side of them that I could shoot. One. Two. Three. 3 was the most recent button I pressed. Let's go to the 3 place. This is it. And nothing. I have no key. Okay, well, I'm at a loss. This is a situation where if any of you have made any observations about a code that might exist for that, often the code was encoded in notes from Andokost himself. I did read a note from him not long ago, though it was like several levels back, I thought. I could go back and take a look at that and see if there's any way to interpret it as a 3-button code. Maybe. That's possible. But yeah, any observations any of you might have made about what could be a passcode here would be appreciated. Anyway, yeah. So it's good to be playing this game again. I hope I'm not stuck here for too long. And I'll see you next time.